I have established an exploratory committee to pursue the possibility of my running for the presidency of the United States as a Republican. We cannot sit passively as our precious democracy slips quietly into darkness.
All right, that is former Massachusetts Governor Bill Weld announcing an exploratory committee to challenge President Trump for the Republican nomination in 2020. In his speech, Governor Weld said Republicans in Washington exhibit all the symptoms of Stockholm syndrome, and he is doing his part to stand up to the schoolyard bully, end quote. Joining us now is former Governor Bill Weld. Good morning, Governor.
Thank you, Allison. Good to be with you.
So what was it for you? What was the straw that broke the camel's back that made you think now is time to jump into this?
Well, I think now is the time because the New Hampshire primary is 1 year away. Time's a wasting. If one's going to make a serious effort to have the actual issues discussed as opposed to a bunch of political palaver and slogans and infighting in Washington, now's the time to do it.
But was there something that President Trump did that made you think, yes, I'm going to get in? I mean, when you say that he's too unstable to carry out the duties of higher office, what was it? How so?
You know, one moment does stick in my mind, and that's the time when the president shooed all the U.S. press out of the Oval Office and brought in Ambassador Kislyak from Russia and Sergey Lavrov from Russia to have his summit meeting with them, with nobody present except TASS, which is the Russian state press organ. That showed contempt for the American people, if anything I've ever seen does.
He shared classified information during that.
Yeah, no, it just gets worse and worse. And the president does not exhibit curiosity about history or even world events. It troubles me that He seeks out the company of people who are dictators and despots, people like Vladimir Putin, like President Kim of North Korea. He said of President Kim, oh, what a great, strong kid. He iced his uncle. He even iced his own brother. I mean, this is mob talk with which I had some familiarity from my days in the Justice Department.
And so was that the moment when you saw what he did in the Oval Office with sharing classified information, was that the moment where you thought, I think I'm going to primary. I'm going to try to launch a primary attack on him.
There was not one moment. I do think the president has shown a tendency to associate with autocrats. I think his domestic instincts are in the same direction. I recall him saying on television, wouldn't it be great if we didn't have to have elections? I'm sure he will say that was a joke. I'm not so sure it was a joke. I mean, the response to my announcement of an exploratory committee has been for everybody to close ranks among the state Republican parties and say, no, we can't have a primary. And the truth is, if the president had his first choice, he wouldn't have a primary and he wouldn't have an election.
So when you say that some of your fellow Republicans have Stockholm syndrome, who are you referring to?
Oh, the general reception in Congress is pretty quiet to some of the president's outrageous conduct and behavior. And by that, I mean they identify with their captor. That's what Stockholm syndrome means. So they identify with him as the emblem of the Republican Party. You couldn't have a much worse emblem, in my view. So it's just everybody going quiet. There's a hush over the Republican Party in Washington, D.C., and they're content to let the president take the lead and be the spear point, and he's going in all the wrong directions, in my view. This whole thing about the wall is a political symbol for him. All the experts would tell you what we really need down there near the border is more drones, more people. And I realize the president campaigned on it, but it doesn't make it any more attractive an issue. It goes right back to the nativism of the Know-Nothing Party in the 1850s, which was half of the Whig Party. The other half became the Republican Party of Abraham Lincoln. Mm. And I'm trying to get us back in the Republican Party of Abraham Lincoln rather than the Know-Nothing anti-Catholic zealots of the 1850s.
I just don't know if that's where the Republican Party is right now. Here's the latest poll by CNN. This is in terms of whether people support the national emergency for a border wall. This is among conservative Republicans, which, of course, is the president's base. 72% say yes, 21% say no. And so when you say that, you know, Republicans are sort of in the sway of the president, I mean, aren't they in the sway of his base? And they don't want to alienate them.
Well, there is a very conservative group, probably not my base for sure. There are 20 primaries where independents, unenrolled voters can come in and vote in the Republican primary. Those will have my attention. But beyond that, in states like New Hampshire, people like to sit down and talk with the candidates and see them up close and personal. You know, I think when you have conversations with people, when they break out of this duopoly, everyone's got to be a Republican or a Democrat, and I'm going to be a Republican because we have to kill the Democrats, or the other way around. If people think for themselves and break out of that that stranglehold of the two parties as they present, then I think there is a good chance that people can be reflective and think there's another way to do things than to waste all this time in Washington.
Well, fighting. Last time around, I mean, you ran as part of a third-party ticket. What do you think of Howard Schultz's run as an independent?
I think people are giving Howard Schultz a bad rap, they say, oh, he's gonna hurt the Democrats because all his votes will come from the Democrats. I don't think so. Howard Schultz is a business guy. I think his votes would come from Trump. The Libertarian vote last time when I was on the ticket with former Republican Governor Gary Johnson, our votes came 3-1 out of Trump, not from Mrs. Clinton. And the Democrats howled that we cost them the election. But think about it. A Libertarian vote is going to be a change vote or a protest vote. Those were not going to go to Mrs. Clinton last time.
So why don't you run as an independent?
I thought about the Libertarian Party again, but I decided I really wanted to go mano a mano with Mr. Trump. There are so many things he's doing that I think are undermining our democratic institutions, and I think he's leading the country in the most fundamental way in the wrong direction. And that clearest shot is in the Republican primary.
And so one of your strategies, as you just said, is to focus on the states where Democrats can vote in the Republican primary.
No. Democrats can't ever take a Republican ballot. It's unenrolled and independent voters who can come in. And that always helped me when I was running. The independents came in and voted for me 6-1 because they saw me as a kind of a centrist, maybe center-right, but somebody who would work across the aisle to try to get things done. That's what's not happening in Washington, D.C. right now.
Well, Governor Bill Weld, thank you for explaining all of this to us. Obviously, we will be watching very closely your next moves.
Thanks, Allison.